Looks like we're just gonna send the boys out there. This tactic looks good. Should I set my set pieces? Meh. Them boys will figure out for itself, you know, the game will set it up for me and I'll be fine and what...
Hello.
What in tarnation?
I know you might not want to set your set pieces, but I'm set piece god. Let me show you your future. If you do set your set pieces.
Ivan Diaz, the center back, stabs at home in his scrum to make it 3-0 and put a little arms, you know, woof. Hey! That's a brace for Ivan Diaz, who is starting to make a real impact on that near post. Ivan for the hat trick! The hat trick for Ivan Diaz!
Well, how digging it out?
Oh, man. Let's go. All right, today it's time to teach you how to be a set piece god. Oh, seriously, we've done a lot of experimenting with set pieces and it's time to dive in and tell you how they work. Let's do it. Now, as you know, I am not the smartest person in the world. Really, Zealand? Well, it's true. I'm sorry to rain on your parade, but what I have done is talk to people that know more than me and experimented within my own save with Oriental Dragon on Twitch, which is a third tier Portuguese site owned by a Chinese dude who makes assigned Chinese players. I'm streaming it on Twitch. Link is down in the description if you want to check that out. But throughout that experimentation, I've been playing with a very direct team, and that direct team is obviously going to rely on set pieces to get the job done. So we've been moving things around in set pieces, responding to talking to intelligent people like the Napster themselves. And I've cooked up a whole set of routines that are going to maximize the amount of goals you're going to be scoring offensively. And we are going to start with corners here today. And we're going to break it down with some elite analysis. This is what my corner looks like right now. There are a couple of changes from what I've done in years past, and I'm going to point those out to you. The first and the most important change is how not to give up goals on set pieces, because set pieces are an equation, right? You're trying to add goals without losing goals. Well, what I was doing with my set piece tactic from yesteryear, you know, back when we had like long beards and I'm so baby face now, I would have one person back in this yesteryear. Well, I started to get absolutely flambéed and filleted by counterattacking plays. It still can happen to you when you have two people back, but one person back, while it used to be something you could get away with to get a bunch of numbers in the box, is now something that you can't get away with. And so two people back is an absolute bare minimum necessity to not just get outscored on your own corners. Because it doesn't matter if you score 10 goals off corners, if you give up 15 goals countering your corner. Don't do that. The second change in philosophy is I no longer play a mixed ball into the box. I used to play a mixed ball into the box because you give a good kick taker, especially somebody that has a lot of talent and intelligence for finding passes, the opportunity to pick out the person they think has the best opportunity to score. But what we're trying to do here is create that best opportunity. We're going to do that following this beautiful line going to the near post. And you're thinking, okay, the ball's going to the near post. Well, then it's going to be going to the person who's making the run on the near post. That's actually wrong. And it took me a while to figure this out. You want to put your best aerial player here, lurking on the near post. Now you're probably thinking I'm insane and you're not gonna trust me because I'm just some dude on the internet wearing a fourth tier tie jersey. But this works. Those highlights you saw in the beginning, Ivan Diaz and his hat trick, came from this. Partly. That second goal you saw from Ivan Diaz with the setup set pieces, he's lurking on the near post. But for some reason, the lurk on near post in Football Manager 21 has him standing right here. And so if he can win this header against the people that are around him, he's gonna have a free shot at the goal as long as the service is okay. Now, there are a couple of things that are going to depend on the ability of your team, and set pieces are always going to depend on the ability of your team as to what you want to do in different areas. And I'm going to point out those different options that you have on your attacking corners. But the lurk on the near post, watch the way Ivan Diaz plays this. Instead of what would have happened in Football Manager 20, where Reese, if we can get the telestrator out here, in arrow, he would go and hover right around this spot. And then all of a sudden, Eric Mendez, who's making the near post run, would be right there and smashing the ball into the back of the net. And that's who you were aiming for. It's not who you're aiming for anymore. Let's slow it down here. Our instant replay brought to you by the subscribe button. Make sure you hit it down below this video. Let's watch how Ivan Diaz plays this as our boy Chico Shin is about to take the corner. Now he hits the ball aiming for this spot, and Eric Mendez is still doing the same thing. He's attacking the near post, but instead of drifting towards the near post to clear space for Eric Mendez, what is happening all the time in this match engine is Ivan Diaz just stays there and heads the ball into the back of the net because he's my best aerial presence on the team. Like, it's beautiful, right? Knee plong marking the keeper is on the same line as Ivan Diaz lurking at the near post. So here are the options that I give to you. You want two people that are not influential in goal scoring, but good at winning the ball. You want them back. And so Quiroz and Bustos are the guys that I have back because they're athletic, they're able to tackle well, and they're not huge goal scoring threats. The next best goal scorer through the air, I want you to put at the position that Eric Mendez is on. Is if for whatever reason, now Ivan Diaz in this tactic is going to get the ball a vast majority of the time. Okay, but Eric Mendez is the next most likely to be on the end of the ball. You want that person to be is good next. The third best person you want on the back post as a distraction, preferably the second tallest person, or maybe even the tallest person if they're not the best in the air, so that they can draw the best defenders away from the action. In my opinion, your best goal scorer should be in this position because if the ball gets flicked on, it's going to draw Guillerme and then he's able to knock it in. You want somebody who can recycle possession and hustle at the top of the box, and then you just throw kind of the extra person who happens to be my diminutive right winger right here. That's how I have it set up. Here's what you can do if your personnel looks a little bit different. Ivan Diaz is not an elite aerial presence. He has 10 heading. He's just big and strong and is going to be able to win a lot of headers, but I'm not going to absolutely dedicate everything I have to getting him the ball. I want some extra person, Nico in this case, in the box so that if the ball gets knocked down, they're able to get there and finish it. But if you have somebody that is really dominant in the air, you want to lurk on the opposite post as well to draw as many defenders away from this goal as possible. That's the change. Like, that's it. Those are your two options here. I suppose if you're supremely confident, you can draw an extra defender by taking off the person charging from the top of the box and putting them over here. If you really have somebody that's just absolutely unstoppable in the air, that would work. It draws an extra defender and opens up more space in the middle. But if you really do have a ton of confidence in the guy on that near post, lurking on the near post to score those goals, if you give him the opportunity, then lurk at the other post. It'll draw defenders away from the front post, which is what you need. And then remember, you have to set this on both sides. So once you set it on one side, set it on the other, and we'll teach you how to save it at the end. This is not the only set piece that you're going to be working on, right? You want to set up the same thing on the other side. The difference between outswinging and inswinging does not seem to be as significant in real life as it is. It doesn't seem to be as significant in Football Manager as it is in real life. Got it. Okay. You set that up on both sides. Now I want you to go to throw-ins. And unsurprisingly, throw-ins are going to work essentially the same way that corners do. And I know what you're thinking. Throw-ins? Yes, if you've not watched the stream, I can create a ton of chances off of throw-ins, even if you have somebody that's not good at throwing. I mean, 9-10 throwing. Sure, they'll get it there less of the time, but what else are you gonna do? Throw the ball short and waste your life? No, we gamble. We throw the ball long. Well, it's not even really a gamble. You're creating chances. I want you to set yourself up the same way. The lurker on the near post is your number one target. The attack near post is your number two target. Your number three target, though not attacking the far post, is marking the keeper. Why is that the case? Because oftentimes the long throw person just isn't going to have the arm to ever get it there. You want to have them close enough that they're going to be able to influence the play. You do want a lurk far post person. So if the ball deflects that direction, they're able to touch it in. That'd be Eric Mendez. And then Nico is floating around the box. Notice how we have two lurk on the edge. And then we have somebody attack the ball from the edge. If it gets knocked down, Knee Plong is there to finish it. We only have one back. That doesn't work on corners. It does work on throw-ins because they're a little less chaotic and velocitous. You know, they're a little more methodical. The ball floating in the air. Equally as devastating, though. Let's watch. As you may or may not have noticed, the last goal that Ivan Diaz scored in that hat trick we watched at the beginning of play, that goal was off of a long throw. And you see that even though we have our long throws set up that way, they essentially end up in a line. And Ivan Diaz is the guy that ends up bursting forward to take it because he's on that lurk at the near post. And all of the other defenders are distracted. He ends up in essentially a 1v1 if the long throw can get there. And what you're looking for are those long lofted throws. Now, the better a long throw taker is, the more often they get you a long lofted throw that's able to cause problems. It's beautiful, beautiful. And just to show you, since you do have your right left on throws as well, it can look on long throws like they're almost positionless, but they are in the same position. And after testing it for multiple seasons already in FM21, the person lurking on the near post is the most likely person to get targeted by the throw-in and to be able to head it into the back of the net. And this array of players is just gonna help create a lot of goals. There's the one most important thing that you have to do, though, that you probably noticed because, hey, damn, that's a big arrow. You have to click on the long throw taker and set the throw to long. Even if they're not good, they will still successfully throw the ball long a lot. It will just take the best player on the team on that side of the field at long throws and have them chuck it. Getting a good long throw taker can be very valuable. As long as they're not a huge loss in every other aspect of the game, it can add goals for you, just like a good free kick taker. So once you've got what I call the Iceland set up on both sides in your free kicks, and you've got the corners that you've got set up on both sides, you are able to actually save all routines. Now we're gonna look at defense. We're gonna look at it less because defense is harder to test for the greatest amount of success. But it's important to look at nonetheless to help you guys not concede. And where defense really plays a part, the only defensive area that I really tweak is defending corners. This is how I have it lined up. I've got my best two aerial people marking the front and the middle of the six. And that has really saved me a lot, because if other teams did this to you, which they essentially do try to do from time to time, it's very hard to score. There are not a ton of goals to be found on corners in Football Manager 21 anyways. There are even less goals to be found on free kicks in Football Manager anyways. And the ones that do get scored are these weird scrum things with players everywhere, all over the place. Take the shortest two guys, put them on the posts, and I don't leave anybody up. Now, late game situations, and this is situational management, you want to look at how many players the other team is leaving back in a corner, and you want to take your best runner with the ball, dribbler, pace, your creativity, the best person running with the ball, put them on the edge of the box, and then take a striker and put them up here. And if you really, if you're down with 10 minutes to go, take two strikers or two forwards, put them up there and have your best dribbler behind him, and you're going to be able to get a lot of counterattacks, because counterattacks off corner kicks are very successful. I'm just a scaredy cat, and so I really go all out to make sure that I can defend set pieces. I've got four lurkers, my tallest two people at the front here, and if you really are dealing with an absolute beast on the front post, maybe the first corner he gets a great chance, do that. It just adds another body that makes the front post even harder to deal with. So set that on both sides, and then we'll go to look at free kick defense just for a second, because free kick defense can be maddening. There are four different types of free kicks. We're just going to focus on two: the indirect wide or the direct small chance of shot. These two are going to cause problems. Indirect deep is going to cause problems as well. I try and make sure I get everybody in the box on these. I haven't set it up in this save because it hasn't caused problems for me yet, but if you are giving up goals, you know, those scrum goals, you're just losing out positioning wise on your free kick defense, direct small chance of shot, indirect wide, indirect deep, you're gonna wanna get a few more people back and into the box to be able to see those away. But remember, counters are potent, so use this wisely. And once it's all done, you save all routines and you can load it up onto all of your tactics. I mean, it won't match up exactly. So if you have a tactic, one tactic that looks like this and another one that looks like this, obviously it won't match up exactly. And going into each match, you are going to want to make sure that you have, you know, your best two primary targets on corner in the right spot, because maybe you rotate your team and a different position has it. Now, my preference in Football Manager would be you have some sort of tier system like we have for set piece takers, like who's making the near post run, Pinto, then Shin, then Holland, depending on who's on the field, right? But we don't have that. So what you have to do is go into your corners right before a match starts and make sure that you have the right guy to aim for in this situation. Make sure you have the right secondary and the right third. And then, of course, you want to do that on your throw-ins as well. Make sure you have the right guy to aim for. It should just take 1 minute while you're setting up your tactic going into a match. And it can be the difference between Ivan Diaz scoring a freaking hat trick and Ivan Diaz scoring exactly no goals and you losing. That's how big of a difference it can be. So if you want to win, you want to be the god of set pieces. You make sure that that's set up going into a match. If you rotate and you load up your routines, you'll make me proud. You make yourself proud and you'll win. And wait. You're like, well, you didn't actually set your set piece takers. It's the easiest thing ever. You sort, you drag. Who do you want taking it? Figure out if you want that person to be heading the ball or taking the corner. Don't put your tallest player taking the corner, even if they're the best, unless they suck in the air. You know, there's a qualifier for everything. So I'm just going to qualify every sentence I say until the end of time. Check out the links in the description. If you like the video, make sure you hit the like button and I will see you guys on a stream. Keep it easy, keep it breezy, keep it beautiful, stay warm.